Hey guys, how you doing? It's time to go home. Put up a video this morning asking people's opinions on if you think dogs know their names, and it seems that we've, I don't know, it's a message sent, not the message received. Okay, guys, we get it, okay? Dogs are intelligent. They can be intelligent. We get that. That's not the point. Does he know that Opie is his name? Like, for example, if you say Jim, I'll look at you. If you say Tim, I'm not going to look at you. But if I say Smopey, he's going to look at me, okay? If I say Topi, he's going to look at me. If you say Kim, I'm not going to look at you. It's not my name. I know that Jim is my name. So that's the point that I'm trying to make. We know he's intelligent. He's a really, really intelligent dog. I mean, he learns things so quickly. You know, he already identifies, he already knows the names of all of his toys. You know, we can just tell him, you know, get your tiger bone, and he knows what it is. I know if I say, where is it, he knows to go look for it. He knows two different commands for sit and lay down. Obviously, he knows sit and lay down when I say it, but I've also taught him to sit when I go psst, and lay down when I go psst, psst. So, and you know, he's learned those. He knows, for gimme paw, we do shake hands. He does that. But we've never done anything in Japanese with him. Everything is in English. And like I said, he learns really, really quick. Like, I remember when I was teaching him to lay down, I was using the clicker training method. And you guys can look that up if you don't know what it is. But I was using clicker training with him. And literally, like, the third or fourth time that I did it, he laid down. And he's had it ever since. And he's really crafty. Isn't that crafty? Crafty's not the right word. He's clever. He does figure things out. I've seen him, you know, figure out how to get around to get something. Or, you know, figure out, you know, the easy problems. I mean, granted, he's not going to go in and take a calculus test for anybody. But I've seen him figure problems. He's really, really smart dog. But does he know that the word Opie equals his name? Okay? Now, I know he reacts to it. When we say Opie, he looks at us. But like somebody said, when we were training him, one of the trainers that we were talking to said, you know, if he shits on the floor, don't go, Opie! Because he'll associate that sound, obviously, and we get that he gets the feelings too. We understand that. They can sense your vibration. We get that. We understand all that. That's not the point. It's the point if we go, Opie, 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 then he's going to associate the word Opie with something bad. That's the point that we're trying to make. Okay, so I'm going to say that dogs don't know that that is their name. And again, if you say Jim, I look up. If you say Kim, why the hell would I look up? It's not my name. But if I say Snoopy, he's going to look up. Okay? So, are they just... They're just identifying certain words and sounds with things that you've taught them, obviously. Like, okay. So, for example, if I say sit, he knows how to sit. But that doesn't mean he understands the word sit. He just understands that when he hears that sound, it means to sit down. I could have taught him chair and to sit down. You know, I say chair, he sits down. He's not going to correct me. No, Mully, that's not the word for sit. You know, okay. So, well, he might. He's pretty smart. But you, okay, that's what I meant. All right, guys. Well, I'll leave it at that. And keep them coming. It's fun reading the stuff. It is. It's pretty interesting. Okay, and we'll talk to you guys later. Sorry, I'm kind of got some traffic coming up here. All right, don't let your meat loaf.